QA/QI professionals tell me that their experience is that the Plan, Do, Study, Act model, or PDSA model, is hard to implement for quality improvement in healthcare. I think this is mainly because it was developed for a different goal, improving efficiency and quality in manufacturing. Because healthcare is human services, and the PDSA was made for manufacturing, I think the PDSA gets lost in translation when being applied to human services. The PDSA works for machines, like in the automotive manufacturing industry, but humans are not machines. Let's consider the five functions of a healthcare quality assurance, quality improvement, or QA/QI department. They are surveillance and monitoring, prioritizing issues to address, conducting research, actions to introduce change, and benchmarking. I have observed that the only functions QA/QI departments have trouble with is research. They are often clinicians with only an introductory knowledge of epidemiology and biostatistics. But they actually need a lot of the advanced research skills that professional epidemiologists and biostatisticians have in order to do rigorous evidence gathering in their healthcare environment. As an alternative to the PDSA model, I propose we instead empower the QA/QI professional with research skills through a three-step process. In step one, the QA/QI professional gains more knowledge in study design. For example, you could take my course series in study design with big data on LinkedIn Learning. You could also try your hand at my new self-published free online course, Understanding Research Forms, Surveys, and Instruments. In step two, the QA/QI professional gains more knowledge in basic statistics. If you want to start with the basics, you could watch 8 hours straight of me lecturing about statistics to an undergraduate nursing class I used to teach, thanks to Free Code Camp for assembling all the lectures together. Step three happens when it's time to do some QA/QI research. In step three, you have an experienced researcher, like me, guide you through the research process of writing a research protocol, obtaining approval, executing the research, and answering your QA/QI research aims. I'm Monica Wahi, an epidemiologist who trains QA/QI professionals on research skills so they can better cover the research functions in their QA/QI departments. If you are thinking, hey, maybe Monica can help me, don't be shy. I'm very friendly, as my customers will tell you. Just email me and we'll set up a free consultation. I look forward to meeting you. Or if you are really just too shy to do that, at least visit our webpage and sign up for my blog updates. My contact information is on the slide.